The first challenge with the hammer is to work out how to pronounce it, which is Mjolnir in our movie at the moment. Until somebody corrects me, I'm sure they will. Mjolnir, the hammer, this awesome weapon for Thor, extraordinarily powerful.
Next. What Thor can do with that hammer, what he's been visualized doing in the comics over 45 years, is spectacular stuff.
Now getting more and more and more acquainted with the detail of the comics, I'm surprised and amazed at quite how much the hammer can do.
He can create lightning storms, tornadoes, he can control the elements.
The power of a sort of galactic nuclear explosion. And we're gonna tease it and surprise you and make you feel the weight of it and also have fun with the many things it can do.
He flies with it, you know, spinning around his hand and off he goes.
He'll throw that hammer, no matter what it hits, it'll always come back to him. This has given us some of the most iconic and spectacular imagery.
The process that we go through for any of the props, and this one in particular, was very long and exciting and fun, and in that we pull our team together, and everyone knows a little something about the hammer, and it's very important to capture all that. And so this particular piece went through a process of illustration. We drew almost 200 Mjolnirs.
I think every time I drew Thor, almost I did a hammer. Charlie had done a lot of variations. He did probably like 60 or 70 different variations at the very beginning of the project.
They paid a lot of attention to paying homage to the Viking era, which is, you know, all the Norse mythology that Thor is based on.
There is significance to everything we've done on the hammer. There are runes on the top of the hammer. Sort of went back and forth and decided what needed to be on this hammer, because there's a lore involved that you don't sway from in certain areas, and this is one of them.
Whoever wields this hammer, if he be worthy, shall possess the power of Thor.
Norse mythology is definitely in there, but at the same time, it goes back to Kirby. So trying to fit those together, I think that's kind of where we started. I think that's also where Ken was like, you know, he does want to get Kirby in there and not completely lose the Norse element.
Stan Lee and Jack Kirby created Thor, and the design work is just spectacular, what's coming together.
Stan Lee and Jack Kirby, when they broke these worlds, they just took our world and tweaked it just a touch.
I was thinking, what could we do that's different? And as far as I knew, there was no god who was a superhero taken from legend. So I thought, let's see, we could do Mars, we could do Jupiter. But somehow I thought to myself, the Norse gods, people don't know as much about them as they do about the Greek and Roman. It would be fun to do a Norse god. And Thor just sounded so dramatic. Thor with his mighty hammer.
The way it's going to emanate light from within it, the way the storm is actually going to emanate from it out into the world, I think, and even the way it's going to swing above his head, you know, we're going right to those comic covers. In every sequence, we want to hit at least two or three classic Thor images.
And so you have Mjolnir. It was kind of guesswork as to what the scale was going to be. So I started with a base size hammer, and then I made two hammers that were 5% larger and two hammers that were 5% smaller, so that when we finally did get Chris in person, we just went through a process of handing him every hammer and did a screen test and sort of saw visually what would work best for him.
Come on!
We basically have three weights of hammer. If we're doing a scene where there's a lot of dialogue and that you'll see the hammer close up, you unfortunately have to wield the heaviest hammer. The heavier the hammer, the more detail it'll give you.
We'd sort of, you know, swap and choose to whatever we could get away with, you know, and often if the lighter one we could use, we'd use that because there was so much movement in the thing. And having to even in the costume, hold your arm up like this was a battle, because the whole thing was, you know, thick leather and pieces of metal, sort of, you know, positioning it this way, so you're sort of pushing. It felt like, you know, 70, 80 pounds above your head.
We make it so that they're interchangeable. You can see that I can unscrew this and change the heads out from a heavy to a lightweight hammer.
the stunt stuff where we were hitting people was kind of more the softer rubber ones, and then the close-ups were a big, shiny, very heavy kind of hammer.
This one, I would tell you, was 8 pounds. The foam one gets down to about 2.5 pounds, and he's able to throw it and catch it and do the things he does.
When the rehearsals, I started kind of spinning it a lot and kind of working out what we could, what I could do without it sort of being, oh, yeah, let's do something with a special effect.
Things and we get to invest his weaponry with awesome powers.
Well, what if it's all the way out?
It's Excalibur, you know, it's the sword in the stone. It has to have that power. When we see it, boy, you're gonna know.